There are caveats that you need to be aware of with how your grip is going to affect your top of the backswing position and how you deliver it. If I have a strong grip here and I'm feeling like I've got my knuckles on top and you think that's a strong grip, that's going to help me release the club. What can happen is as we take the club back, we can end up sort of having too much flexion, okay? And that's going to create too much angle on the wrist and a very sort of shut face. So subconsciously, you're going to know that that face is shut. So you're going to end up standing up this way to try and square it, basically. Because, you know, we're not all Dustin Johnson who can rotate and deliver that club straight back at the ball. If you don't rotate and just stall the body, see how open that club face is as I sort of come into the ball? And that's happening because I've got too strong a grip. Likewise, if we have too much of a weak grip, we're going to actually do the opposite, which is over sort of rotate and extend the wrist because we're at the full end range of motion, basically. So it's only going to create more of a pattern where we're opening the club face, okay? And then we deliver it, the club face is going to be open, but subconsciously you might know, well, it's open, so I'm going to try and square it over, and you'll end up smothering it this way. So in golf, there are not black and white answers. There's always a little bit of gray, and you have to understand not just how the grip affects it, but how the rest of the body and the club face responds to that. I mentioned technology at the beginning, and one of my favorite tools for myself, for students, and many people that I've recommended this device to is the HackMotion. The reason why this is so good is because it's telling you what you are doing. It's not trying to manipulate or force you into any other positions that when you sort of take the training aid off, you're going to lose without it. This enhances the exact data that we need to see what you're actually doing. You know, it literally doesn't lie. So by wearing this device, we can get tons of different metrics to see what our wrists are doing. Now, there's multiple options. You can put them on different wrists, but I just want to talk about the lead wrist right now. So I'm going to open up the app, and we can see here, you know, we can do different things. We can browse drills. We can see past data. We can even see what the tour players are doing, but let's keep it super simple. So we can flexion, which is this movement here. Okay, so we're flexing there, and then we're extension there. So flexion and extension, okay? So with a strong grip, what can happen is, as I said, we're gonna get too much flexion. You can see in the image here, we're just a little bit too shut because that's my range of motion. I've reached my full range of motion here. I can't, or not very easily, keep the club moving this way so that club face stays a bit more neutral. My instinct is going to have it do much more of this kind of action where I'm a lot more laid off, okay? And as I showed you before, that's not always going to help us as we're trying to swing through. So you can see here, you know, too much flexion at the top, too much change in the wrist patterns. And that's in essence what I'm trying to explain. When you start a certain way with full range of motion done, basically too much extension this way, right? So there we had too much cupping, which is, this is extension, that is flexion, right? If we set up that way, my arms can't continue to stay there. They're always going to figure it out to not hurt myself in some ways, and I'm going to end up opening that club face quite a lot. That's what's going to happen there. So I'm here, it's going to end up opening, and the ball's going to go way off to the right. So you think, what do I do then? The beauty of the HackMotion is we can educate ourselves and figure out what works best for you, me, you, whatever. And we can experiment. We can experiment with a stronger grip starting here. Okay, so we've got a stronger grip. What's that going to do? What are my tendencies to reach at the top of the swing? And am I going to be too extended this way? Or am I going to have too much flexion this way? Right? Because Everything is a response to something else. If you don't know what your grip is doing when it comes to the top of the backswing, you're really going to struggle to find any sort of consistency. And the hack motion can give you the hard data to start experimenting. Maybe you do benefit more from a stronger grip, because maybe you don't actually have too much flexion there and you can rotate through a little bit easier. Okay? You can rotate through a little bit easier to get the straight shots. But maybe it's going to hinder you. So experimenting to see what you do best and really seeing how the club reacts to your body and to that grip position. The main crux of this lesson is understanding how your grip, how your wrists, and how your body movement affect the club face specifically for you. And you can remove a lot of that guesswork away with the hack motion device. If you don't have one of these, you can still start creating some awareness and hitting shots to see where does the ball go when I change my grip, when I make it stronger, when I make it more weak. And you can record yourself to see what happens when you have a stronger grip, what happens towards the top of the swing, and where's the club when you're coming back down for delivery. Are we too shut? Are we too open? So there's the checkpoints you can look at. Grip, top of backswing, into delivery, because everything you do at setup here is going to affect the backswing and it's going to affect the delivery into impact. And as I say to every single golfer, you have to test these things out. I want you to check out how the wrists affect every single shot around the green. When you start looking at the wrists, you'll fix a lot of your swing challenges, shall we say. See you next.